हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर हैप्पी एंड हेल्दी। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू कैन सी, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी यूनिट 3 होम सिकनेस, एंड दिस इज योर लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो। टुडे वी विल फिनिश द चैप्टर। सो लेट्स सी। सो एज वी नो, वी हैव कवर्ड till paragraph 31 and we have to continue from paragraph 32. So without wasting our time, let's see paragraph 32. So we know that the author, pretending to be suffering from the appendix, he tells the matron of the boarding school, okay, and at last the matron decided to send him at his home, and the headmaster called his mother, okay, and when the matron informs the narrator that his mother is coming to receive him, then the author did not respond anything and he tried to show that he is very sick, but internally he was very happy, okay, he was very joyful. Okay students, so let's see from paragraph 32 we have to study. Okay, let's see. I was taken home across the Bristol Channel and I felt so wonderful at being away from the school that I very nearly forgot I was meant to be ill. The narrator tells us that he was taken home across the Bristol Channel. This is any place name, Bristol Channel. Okay. And he felt so wonderful at being away from the school that he forgot about his sickness. Is it clear? When he was taken to home, okay, then he forgot that he is sick, okay, due to overjoyful, due to happiness. Okay, that afternoon I had a session with Dr. Dunbar in Cardiff and I tried the same tricks all over again. The narrator tells us that that afternoon when he was taken home, okay, that afternoon he had an appointment with the doctor, and whose name was Dr. Dunbar in Cardiff. Okay, he lives in Cardiff. So he has an appointment with the doctor. Okay, and I tried the same trick all over again. When the narrator was sent to the doctor, then the author adopted the same trick all over again. The trick that he had accepted, he had adopted at the time of the school board, okay, school, same trick he adopted here also. Okay, he clutching his stomach right side and he crying with pain. Okay, so he pretending that he is suffering from appendix. Now see further. But Dr. Dunbar was far wiser and more skillful than either the matron or the school doctor. The narrator tells us that Dr. Dunbar was very clever and very intelligent. He was more skillful in the comparison of the matron or the school doctor. Okay? Now see paragraph 33. After he had prodded my stomach and I had done my helping routine, he said to me, now you can get dressed again and sit yourself on that chair. Mr. Dunbar again checked his stomach with his fingers and the narrator tried to show that he is suffering from a severe pain. Okay, when the doctor push his stomach with his fingers. Then at the place where he feels pain, when the doctor puts that part of his body, then the author cried loudly. He pretending to be having a severe pain. Okay, he started crying, he started weeping. At last the doctor said to him, now he can get dressed and sit himself on that chair. Okay, the doctor asked him to dress and sit himself on a chair. Now see paragraph 34. He himself sat down behind his desk and fixed me with a penetrating but not unkindly eye. Okay. He himself sat down behind his desk. It means to say Dr. Dunbar, he himself sat down just behind the author. Okay. And he penetrating. What is the meaning of penetrating? It means to say steady and sharp, as if looking into the other's mind. Okay. It means to say observing. We can say observing carefully. So Dr. Dunbar sat behind the author and he observing him very carefully. Okay, is that clear? He was observing him very carefully. At last, when the doctor finished observing him, he tells the author that he is faking. He is pretending to be ill. Okay, he is not suffering from appendix. He was not suffering from any disease. Just he tried to show that he is suffering from appendix. Is that clear? Now see paragraph 35. How do you know I blurt out? What is the meaning of blurt out? Blurt out means to say something suddenly. As the author heard from the doctor that he is pretending to be sick, so the author all of sudden blurt out. He all of sudden asked the doctor how he can say, how he knew that he is pretending to be sick. Okay. Now see paragraph 36. Because your stomach is soft and perfectly normal, he answered. Dr. Dunbar answered him that he is pretending to be ill because his stomach is soft and perfectly normal. Okay. Now see further line. If you had an inflammation down there, the stomach would have been hard and rigid. It's quite easy to tell. Dr. Dunbar further tells him that if he had an inflammation, what the meaning of inflammation? Inflammation means a painful swelling caused by an infection. So the doctor tells him if he had an painful swelling, okay, in his stomach, then the stomach would have been hard and rigid. Okay, so it's very easy to find out that he is not suffering from any disease, just he pretending to be ill. Is that clear? Now see paragraph 7. I kept silent. When the doctor replied him, the narrator did not answer him. He was kept silent. Okay, he kept silent. He did not say a few words, a single words. Now see further. I expect you are homesick, he said. And after that, doctor replies, okay, the narrator, that he thinks he is suffering from homesickness. Okay. I nodded miserably. And the narrator tells us that when the doctor guessed that he is suffering from homesickness, then the narrator nodded his head in the positive. Okay. He replied that yes, he is homesickness. He is suffering from homesickness. Now see paragraph 40. Everyone is at first, he said. Okay. The doctor tells him that everyone faced this problem very first. You have to stick it out. What is the meaning of stick it out? We have a word here, stick it out. ओके स्टिक इट आउट मीन्स फेस एन अनप्लीजेंट सिचुएशन विथ करेज एंड पेशेंस. सो द डॉक्टर एडवाइजेज द नरेटर दैट ही शुड फेस द डिफिकल्टीज एंड अनप्लीजेंट सिचुएशन विथ पेशेंस एंड विथ करेज. ओके एंड डू नॉट ब्लेम योर मदर फॉर सेंडिंग यू अवे टू बोर्डिंग स्कूल. ही ऑल्सो टेल्स द नरेटर दैट ही शुड नॉट ब्लेम हिज मदर फॉर सेंडिंग हिम अवे टू बोर्डिंग स्कूल. ओके सी इंसिस्टेड यू वर टू यंग टू गो. द डॉक्टर टेल्स द नरेटर दैट हिज मदर डिड नॉट वॉन्ट टू सेंड हिम बोर्डिंग स्कूल बट इट वॉज आई हु परस्यूडेड हर. ओके इट वॉज द राइट थिंग टू डू. द डॉक्टर टेल्स द नरेटर दैट हिज मदर डिड नॉट वॉन्ट टू सेंड हिम बोर्डिंग स्कूल एज ही वॉज वेरी लिटिल ही वॉज वेरी यंग. ओके बट इट वॉज डॉक्टर डुनबर्ग हु परस्यूडेड. वॉट द मीनिंग ऑफ परस्यूडेड? Made her change her mind through request and argument. We can say convince. Okay. So the doctor tells him that it was he who persuaded her mother that it was the right time to send him boarding school. And that is why his mother sent him to the boarding school. Life is tough and the sooner you learn how to cope with it, the better for you. The narrator tells the doctor encourages the narrator that the life is very tough. Okay, the life is full of difficulties, the life is full of unpleasant situation, and the sooner he learn how to cope with. Dear student, we have a meaning cope with. So cope with, we can say cope with means tolerate to. We can say to tolerate or to face. Okay, to tolerate or to face. Okay, so the doctor tells him that as soon as he learn how to cope with the problem, the situation, it will be better for him. So that is why his mother sent him to boarding school at the advice of the doctor. Is that clear? Now see further paragraph 41. What will you tell the school? I ask him trembling. And after that the narrator tells him that trembling he asked the doctor what he will tell the school. Okay. Now see paragraph 42. I will say you had a very severe infection of the stomach which I am curing with pills. He answered smiling. Then the doctor tells the narrator that he will inform the school that the narrator is suffering from a severe infection of the stomach and he is curing him with pills. Is that clear? Now see further. It will mean that you must stay home for 3 more days. The doctor tells the narrator that it means to say that he can stay at home at least 3 days. Okay, now see further lines. But promise me you will not try anything like this again. The doctor takes promise from the author that he will not pretending to be sick ill in the future. Now see further. Your mother has enough on her hands without having to rush over to fetch you out of school. Okay, so the doctor tells the narrator that his mother, okay, was very serious and okay, she was very emotional when she heard about his sickness, and she rushed over to take him out of the school as soon as she heard about his sickness. Okay, now see paragraph 43. I promise, I said, I will never do it again. And the narrator promised the doctor that he will never do it again in his life. ही विल नेवर प्रटेंड टू बी सिक. ओके सो स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू हैव गॉट दिस ऑल आइडिया अबाउट द चैप्टर दैट वी हैव डन. सो टिल देन वॉच द वीडियो एंड एन्जॉय.